The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Many of Jesus' disciples who were listening said, "This saying is hard. Who can accept it?" Since Jesus knew that his disciples were murmuring about this, he said to them, "Does this shock you? What if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life, while the flesh is of no avail. The words I have spoken to you are Spirit and life. But there are some of you who do not believe." Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe and the one who would betray him. And he said, "For this reason, I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father." As a result of this, many of his disciples returned to their former way of life and no longer accompanied him. Jesus then said to the 12, "Do you also want to leave?" And Simon Peter answered him, "Master, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and are convinced that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord. The United Tribes of Judaism were the first people to worship the one creator God, a God for whom no statue or image could express God's divinity. God is ineffable, beyond any merely human word or expression or image. However, the Jewish people had great trouble shaking off their pagan roots. This is a theme woven into the fabric of the entire Old Testament, the temptation to fall back to their pagan roots. The people were surrounded by Amorites, Canaanites, Edomites, Philistines, all of these cultures with their multitudes of gods. The temptation to return to their pagan roots must have been very strong. When the pagans said to the Israelites, "Show us your God," they couldn't. They couldn't do that. That was not an advantage in a materialistic culture then or now. The urge to go back to the comforts of good old paganism, the nostalgia for better days past. Do we go forward to serve the Lord or back to gods that cannot save? The first reading is the final chapter of the book of Joshua, chapter 24. It begins with the prophet gathering the people and insisting they make a choice. It is the moment of decision. Either they serve the Lord or they fall back to their pagan ways. It's a turning point for the people. Go forward, serving the Lord, or cling to this vestigial impulse towards magical thinking, incantations, statues, images, convincing themselves that this god or that god will cure everything. Magical thinking, cultic behavior, fear-based spirituality, belief in warrior gods that inflict punishment on our enemies. These false gods are still with us today. And the fact is that practicing our Christian faith takes commitment, discernment, a conscious choice, and discipline. Disciples are those who place themselves under a discipline, a rigorous way. For the early Christians, a deadly way in an age of martyrdom. And yet the more martyrs the leaders created, the more people wanted to worship a God worth dying for, because a God worth dying for is a God worth living for, a God worth loving. The pagan gods didn't love. Do we fall back or go forward to serve the Lord? After thousands of years, the choice remains the same for humanity, for us. At this turning point, presented in the first reading, the prophet proclaims all that the Lord has done for the people. We didn't get to hear that because it got chopped out in that chapter 24, but all the things that God had done for the people and how quickly people forget. It goes back to Abraham, God's promise to him, Isaac, Jacob, Esau, Moses, Aaron, the liberation from the Egyptians, the victories against all the gods of Canaan. All of it, God initiated, held by God, but ignored or forgotten by the people. Brothers and sisters, it is when things go well that we are most in danger of falling back, because we get to think it's all about us doing it. We have a natural tendency towards a certain spiritual ennui, leading to a lack of discipline. And yet, even so, God continues to reach out to love you through life every moment, supported by God's loving invitation. So yeah, many of Jesus' disciples, they made their choice. They went back to former ways because it's easier, because it's more comfortable. And if you don't believe me, just try changing a habit that you have. We yearn for the good old days before things got complicated, seeking the fulfillment of a nostalgia which can never be satisfied because it was never that good. Peter, thank goodness, and he'll pay with his life for that choice, will not go back. To whom would we go, Lord? You hold the keys to eternal life. The true disciples of Christ set their faces like flint, and we go forward because we are the God seekers. And when we knock, the door will be opened.